Hi, I'm Ben, and in this video, we'll be looking at the ISA 500 application in CVU V3. When you first run CVU, you'll be presented with this window here. On the left-hand side, you have a list of applications within CVU, and on the right-hand side, you have a list of all communication ports and network connections on your PC. When you first run CVU, CVU will automatically scan all communication ports at every known baud rate. It'll then automatically detect any sensors connected to your computer. In this example here, two sensors have been detected. One is the ISS 360 sonar, and the other is the ISA 500 altimeter, as shown in the centre of the screen. If you look at the icon for the ISA 500 altimeter, you'll find you're given a little bit more information, such as the serial number of the sensor, the firmware version, and also how it's connected to the software. In this particular example, we can see it's connected via COMPORT 5 at a baud rate of 105/200. If you double-click on the ISA 500 icon, you'll be taken into the ISA 500 application. Now in the application, the top left-hand corner, you've got the distance reading being reported by the ISA 500. Every time the sensor pings, you get a green flash of this light here, and a distance reading reported. And below the distance reading, you also get an energy and correlation value. Also reported is the temperature of the ISA 500 internal electronics, and if you have an ISA 500 with integrated heading, pitch and roll, you'll also get heading, pitch and roll readings and a little 3D model of the sensor to show you how it's orientated at any one time. In the middle of the screen, you've got a graph which is basically showing distance measurements over time, and on the left hand side of the screen you have a number of icons. Now if we start with the top icon, this is the ISA 500 settings. So if you enter the settings, you'll be presented with a window like this. The first settings window is all to do with the ISA 500 acoustics. Now, the ISA 500 is a highly configurable altimeter. You can configure many parameters. For example, you can change the detection mode. You can operate in first detect, strongest, or seabed tracking. First detection mode is ideal if you're working in a confined space where there's a lot of multi-path, multi-echo capability, such as inside a tank. Strongest echo is better for open water activity, and if you're wanting to track the seabed, then there's a seabed tracking option as well. You can also enable and disable tilt correction. So if you have an ISA 500 with integrated AHRS, enabling tilt correction will automatically convert slant ranges into actual altitude. So it'll correct for pitch and roll of your vehicle and give you a more stable altitude reading. You can disable this if you wish and just have pure range readings from the sensor. You can then configure minimum and maximum ranges. So for your minimum range, anything below the set value will never be detected by the ISA 500, and your maximum range, anything above that value will never be detected by the ISA 500. So you can basically gate the ranges that you're wanting the sensor to look over. You can also set the frequency. The ISA 500 is a broadband altimeter, so you can run it from anywhere from 400 to 600 kHz. You can set the speed of sound to give you an accurate distance reading. You can set the pulse length and the pulse amplitude. You can also put in any distance offsets as required. Moving on to the next settings window, the analog output. The ISA 500 can provide you a serial ASCII output, but it can also provide you a scaled output. It can provide a scaled current, or it can provide a scaled voltage, and you can set up the scaling. So you can set up the start and stop voltages and your minimum and maximum ranges to scale that over. The next setting option is your multi-echo setup, and this is the number of echoes to be reported on from a single ping. So most applications, ISA 500 is used just to give a single range reading, but it can also give you multiple range readings from a single ping. And you can set how many range readings you want the sensor to report on. The next option is your connection. So in this window here, you can select the serial mode, which can be RS-232, RS-485, or RS-485 terminated. You can also set the required baud rate, together with the word length, parity, and the number of stop bits required. Your next option is the output string. So this is the output string for the distance reading. There's a number of pre-configured strings, all of which are detailed in the ISA 500 manual. So you've got a number of impact subsea strings, and you have a number of third-party strings to allow the ISA 500 to emulate other altimeters in the market. If the particular string you require is not there, You also have the custom button, which allows you to create your own ASCII output string in the exact format which you require. You can also set up in this window what the ISA500 should do if no returns are received, where the output's a zero reading or a maximum reading. You can also tell it how many times you want it to ping an output to reading, anywhere from a fraction of a second up to 100 hertz. You can also set up the interrogation method, so if you want to interrogate the ISA500 and command it to ping, you can enable that and also set the parameter for it to respond to. And you can also select interrogate via TTL if you want to trigger it via TTL, and you can select whether it's the falling edge or the rising edge of the TTL pulse which it triggers on. Then if you have a ISA500 which has integrated AHRS, you'll have the AHRS settings option. And in here you can configure everything to do with the heading, pitch and roll. To start off with, you can select the orientation. By default, it's assumed that the ISA500 has the connector pointing upwards and the transducer pointing downwards. However, you can change it to be inverted or pitched over or rolled over. And these just set the your reference point for your pitch and roll and heading to make sure you get accurate readings. Once installed on the vehicle, if there's any inaccuracies in how it's been installed, you can apply minor offsets to the heading, pitch and roll. You can also apply a magnetic declination offset, enable inertial mode, calibrate the magnetometers, and set up your turns counter for the sensor as well. Then the last option to look at here is your AHRS output. So this configures the ASCII output string for the heading, pitch and roll side of things. And as before, there's a number of impact subsea strings, and there's a number of industry standard strings as well, all of which are documented in the ISA500 manual. And again, as before, if there's a string you require which isn't there, or you want a slightly different string, you have the custom option to go in, edit a string, or create an entirely new string to meet exactly what you require. And like the altitude or range output, you can select how many times per second the string is output. You can also enable interrogation and set up the parameter for the ISA500 to respond to. And you can also have the output on a TTL interrogation as well. So that's all the core ISA500 settings. So if we return to the main screen, if we look at the left-hand side again, there's a ping button, so you can manually trigger a ping from the sensor. There's also a ping rate, and this sets the ping rate of the sensor when it's connected to the SeaView V3 software. So it's currently set to 1 Hz. We can increase it to 5 Hz or 10 Hz, or we can set the sensor to run at maximum rate. So if it's set to maximum, it'll basically ping as fast as it can given your minimum and maximum range setting. And as we change the ping rate, you can see that green light flashes at the designated rate, and that basically flashes once per ping on the sensor. At any time, you can enable a log file by clicking here, and it'll just record all the ISA500 readings to a log file and timestamp them. You can clear the graph data here if you want to start afresh. You've got display options, so you can set exactly which parameters you want to be showing on screen. So for example, we could turn off the temperature, we could turn off the heading, pitch and roll, so you've just got altitude and the little 3D model of the ISA500, or we can enable all those back on again. We can turn on the turns counter, so it'll show you the number of turns the ISA500 has made. And the last item I'll show you here is the multi-echo output capability. So if you click Show Multi-Echo, it'll bring up another graph at the bottom of the screen. You can click and make this graph a bit larger. And this graph will essentially show you every single return the ISA500 sees from a single pulse being sent out. So it gives you a good appreciation of exactly the acoustic environment in which the ISA500 finds itself. Or if you want to make multiple measurements to different targets that fall within the 6-degree conical beam from the ISA500, this is a good way to do it. One other item to consider, on the right-hand side of the screen, we have a graph options button. And this allows you to edit the graph display. So you can turn off the fill, you can have it draw points for every ping, you can turn off draw lines. You can basically alter things to get the exact graph that you want to have on screen. So that's the ISA 500 application in CVU V3. If you have any questions regarding this, please do not hesitate to contact us at support@impactsubc.co.uk.